What's up guys, my name is Uncaged Games, welcome back to another video. Today, I'm doing the 10 things that I noticed in the Comet Pack 2 gameplay trailer, so let's get started. The first thing I noticed was Cyber Smoke. He had a different look to him compared to the Comet Pack 2 reveal trailer, where in that trailer he was blue lighted, and in this trailer he is red lighted. So is this an alternate costume, or is this his new design because NetherRealm doesn't want Sector and Cyber Smoke to have the same light up scheme? The next two things I noticed was on the pit stage. One of them you guys probably already saw, that it was Blaze in the background fighting. That's cool. Is he gonna be a playable character? Probably not. He's just in here because there's always someone in the background fighting on the pit stage. So don't hold your breath about Blaze being a playable character. Now the second thing I noticed was something that a lot of you guys probably didn't notice. If you look at the pit stage, there are fire lanterns throughout the whole bridge. But if you look all the way on the left side and the right side, the lanterns are not red like they are in the middle of the map, but they are blue. My guess is the blue lanterns are the ones that you can interact with and throw it at your opponent. Right now I only see two interactables, which is fine. I don't want a lot. This map is going to be very straightforward and I like it. I'm going to choose it every time I play Mortal Kombat X when this map gets released. The next thing I noticed is Leatherface's alternate color. In the beginning of the trailer you see him wearing like a green type of shirt, but later in the trailer you see him actually using a different color outfit. It's more of like a, I don't know how to describe it, like a lighter red, brownish color. Anyways, you guys can see that it's not green, so that is his alternate colors. I just thought that was cool. I was like, wait a second, did you change outfit, Leatherface? You can't just do that and then, oh wait, you did? Alright. The next thing I noticed is something that probably everyone noticed when they watched the trailer, and that is Triborg looks OP, man. Which is, I don't know if that's a good or bad thing. I love Triborg so far. I can't wait to play as the character. Like, I really just want to pick the character, go into training, and just spend hours upon hours trying to learn stuff with him. He looks so good, but that's my problem. That's the thing I noticed. He looks strong. Very strong. The next thing I notice is how fast Baraicho is. He is literally flying all over the screen in this trailer, and that is so cool. A lot of people said Baraicho is gonna suck, and you know what? He might still suck. Out of the trailer, he looks like he's the fastest character. Next, he's like close to Cyber Smoke. Cyber Smoke was pretty fast, but Baraicho was flying, doing like airplane jumps. He has a cane, which is cool. He had a cane in the previous MK game, so that's cool that he has one in one of his variations. The next thing I noticed in this trailer is the alien, how he rolls with a squad. Did you see that part in the trailer where there's literally like two other things, not counting the fighters, that enter the arena? Like there's that little insect thing that came out of the egg, went on Jackie's face, and then there was another alien that jumped from the sky doing it like an overhead move to Jackie. Dude, if I was Jackie, I would call for backup. This next thing I noticed was very quick in the trailer, and it was the alien's fatality. Now, in the fatality, you can see that Jackie's in some type of web, gunk, whatever you want to call it, but she's not in the normal map. She looks like she's in some type of alien base. See, I don't watch the alien movies, so maybe this is like a really good reference to the movies, but the only thing I'm noticing here is Jackie is screwed. Speaking of fatalities, the next thing I noticed is probably one of the sickest fatalities, and it's not even the full fatality, we only see a glimpse of it, and it is Triborg's fatality. And oh my goodness, if you look at it, Cyrax and Cyber Smoke holding Sub-Zero from each arm, and then Sector coming up doing like a dragon uppercut. Oh my god, can this character get any more cooler? Like, goodness gracious, NetherRealm, I can't handle it, man, just give me the character already. And the last thing I noticed, or actually did not notice in this trailer, was at the end of the trailer, it said everything that Comet Pack 2 includes, but the pit was not included. So is the pit a free DLC? And if so, NetherRealm might release more free DLC. That means more skin packs and more stages, which would be awesome. Because all we see in this Comet Pack 2 is we're getting like one new skin pack, which is the Apocalypse skin pack, and then a bunch of old stuff that we already have. So maybe they're actually giving us some free DLC. But those were the 10 things I noticed in this Mortal Kombat X Comet Pack 2 trailer. Hopefully this video made you guys notice some things that you guys might have not noticed the first time watching the Comet Pack 2 gameplay trailer. If so, give the video a like. And if I missed something that you guys noticed, feel free to leave in the comments and I'll try to check it out when I watch the trailer once again, because this trailer is freaking awesome. But like the video if you guys enjoyed, subscribe if you guys are new. My name's Uncaged Games and you just got caged. Oh my god, all three of them enter? Yo! Right, Joe drinking. Nice. And we see the